Nothing says fun like talking about research. But in this case, this research on the ALERT program is some of the most exciting we've seen to date. And that's saying a lot, because we have over 30 pages of citations related to the ALERT program in our literature and research document that show positive research results from all over the world. And a lot of the research that's been used on the ALERT program has shown good improvement in self-regulation and executive functioning. Thank goodness! And that research has typically utilized behavioral research measures. And while those are really important, what we now have from these two Canadian research projects that we want to highlight here is that we have some information about physiological measurements. And I brought my notes because I want to get it right for you here. In these two projects, they used functional MRIs to detect the changes in brain activity before and after the ALERT program was implemented. Now, these kind of studies can get even a non-research geek excited. Listen to this. The results in these two projects suggested that the intervention using the ALERT program intervention led to, and I'm going to read a quote here, increased cortical gray matter and related improvements in self-regulation skills, including improved emotional and inhibitory control. And that's the end of the quote. That is a mouthful, but it's big and it's important. And this is exciting stuff, because these two research projects involved children who have many challenges with executive function and self-regulation, children with FASD. Now, here's another exciting quote from these researchers, because they say it better than I can. Our findings suggest the ALERT program does improve functional integrity in the neural circuitry for behavioral regulation in children with FASD. And findings suggest that the treated FASD groups treated with the ALERT program were starting to resemble children never exposed prenatally to alcohol. That's the end of the quote. I'm going to say, wow, how great is that? To see actual changes in brain activity after using the ALERT program, similar to children who did not have exposure to prenatal alcohol. Big stuff. So, these two research studies demonstrated a correlation between structural physical changes of the nervous system with the functional behavioral changes that were the result of using the ALERT program. And I'm going to do another quote from the researchers. Can you tell I'm hyped up about this? This research provides hope that effective therapies can have a positive impact on the brain damage caused by prenatal exposure to alcohol. End quote. And of course, we're really proud that this research proves that the ALERT program is one of those effective therapies. Now, when Mary Sue and I started working with clients who needed support with self-regulation and executive function, we observed a great deal of functional behavioral changes when we were using the ALERT program. And intuitively, as clinicians, we felt like there must be some changes occurring physiologically and structurally. And this research is exciting because it begins to actually demonstrate and examine this correlation. Now, to have validation that the ALERT program not only improves self-regulation abilities, but makes positive changes to brain activity and brain structures, well, now that's some good, heady stuff.